You'll have to get over it.
Yeah.
There you go. There you go, buddy. That's a good boy. There you go. Relax. That's a boy. There you go. He's relaxing. That noise he makes, that means they're relaxed.
In here.
What?
When they do that, that means they're relaxed. They're relaxing.
Yeah. He's getting more into it. He's like, okay, we're cool. I'm feeling a little bipolar right now.
He's just sensitive.
I'm going to make my and kick at the same time.
So this is very important, not only to help guide him, but also for him mentally. Very important. Pressure doesn't have to get any stronger. It just needs to be constant and consistent until there's hope.
He's stubborn.
Learning is critical thinking process. You have to be able to process. Figure out a problem, not just fight it.
He's feisty.
We'll get it.
I've never seen him do that.
Yeah, you find, that's why I wanted to go with him on the ground first, because you find all sorts of little things like this that you just want to get out before you get in the saddle. And for me, this is more about just him being able to mentally process things.
Right.
I just want him to know it's just go forward.
He's really sensitive to just about everything I do.
And so we need to help him understand that all of this is just to guide him, just to help guide him where he needs to go. And so this is just about his brain being able to say, okay, let's process that. Say, okay, kicking obviously isn't working. Let's go ahead and process what I have to do to get rid of that feeling. So as soon as he goes forward, it goes away, and then the next time it's important we go from no whip. Good.
Good boy,
no
there.
No whip to whip raising. And then if you have to, you touch. And the touch is just to be light and consistent. It doesn't have to be strong. It's light, consistent. The very worst thing that can happen is that it goes away when he kicks out. When he holds it all. All we have to do. Stay there consistent until he goes forward. Good. It's a process. How do you think about it? Ask you a question, you figure out the answer to the question, and then you go away.
Good. No, he's figured it out. I'm good. He'll respect it and listen to it. I said he'll respect it and listen to it, the whip.
Hold on. hold in for just 1 second. I just need to make sure things are okay. This is going to go out. It's not good. It's not bad.
Okay. It's fine. Bob.
I couldn't find you. You're missing some really cool stuff here.
Okay. Alright, bye. Good boy.
He's talking to me. You fall asleep there, huh? You fall asleep?
There you go, good boy. Good boy.
So last time I went for a red dude, I got my nose broken.
I like to do once a week.
If you want me to scratch you there, I'll scratch you. Somebody's trying to get their phone.
That's Sophie. I think that's Sophie. Somebody else has a white sheet. There you go, good boy. think he might end up just being dressage. We'll see.
I was thinking that he's going to make a good dressage horse.
That's what I was looking at when I first bought him, but I would like to jump. I think it would be fun just to give him something else to do. But I don't know. I think he likes dressage a lot. We'll see. And my husband would be fine with that. He doesn't want me jumping, but it's fun.
I know. My father got only one Christopher. You've had his accidents.
I remember that.
Because I had to that jump off the
cliff. Something that's very impossible, a little bit scary, and let's teach him that he can work through that process mentally. Make it a good thing. Make it a guide. Because eventually that thing's going to help him. It's going to guide him.
Oh, you know what I have.
The rest of the work, he's going to come on to you. Quite easily. I'm very sure. Once he just knows a little bit more about how to balance and move around, it's going to be quite easy. And I am still keeping the whip with me, I'm still keeping the spurs on, because him mentally, he just needs to accept all things. All things will help guide him. All things will be okay. I'm going to start out with the same concepts as I did with Morgan's horse. Interacting with it, saying, okay, no coming behind, no coming above. He's going to try both. It's the way he's made, he's going to try both. He's going to try to come behind, and he does, and I'm lifting him up, I'm vibrating upwards. If he comes, if he comes above, I'm going to lift my hands with him, put constant pressure on him until he gives and has the desire to go back towards the ground. He already wants to hold himself a lot better in his withers than in many, so you got the advantage there. It's just a matter of making it better and making the guiding a lot more sensitive. This right side is going to be a little bit more crooked, a little more trouble, but that's all right. Help him out. Make him straight again. So my outside rein right now is just making sure that he doesn't bend too much to the inside. My inside rein is lifting up, putting pressure. I'm saying, what are you going to do with that pressure? Are you going to come above with it? Are you going to come behind with it? Or are you going to accept that pressure, help it guide you, instead of letting your body? I'm testing him a lot. As long as he stays like he is right now, he's reaching out towards my hands. I make sure he can't move through my hands, but I want him to reach out towards me. A little test the inside hand there.